Hi friends, in last video we had seen introduction of coaxial cable, transmission line and behavior of electromagnetic field in a conductor with high frequency. Today we will see construction of coaxial cable.
This picture shows the construction of coaxial cable. This is conductor and this one is insulation, and it is also called as dielectric. This one is APL and this is braiding, and these both is called as shield. This one is jacket. Now we will see one by one. First one is conductor. Any material that allows the electric current pass through it is called conductor. All metals are conductors, but we use only copper, aluminium, steel and combination of all these metals. Why we choose only three metals? Because these metals has all the properties which are need for cable manufacturing. Why we need conductor? Conductor transfers signal from one end to another end. For that, first and important properties is resistivity. Conductor resistivity, ohm meter. Silver is excellent conductor. It has a resistivity of 1.59 × 10⁻¹. But it is not used due to its higher cost. After this, second good conductor is copper. It has a resistivity of 1.68 × 10⁻¹. Sometime we need annealed copper for cable manufacturing. After annealing, resistivity of copper increased to 1.72 × 10⁻¹. After copper, next one is gold. It has a resistivity of 2.64 × 10⁻¹. It is also not used due to its higher cost. Then next one is aluminium. It has a resistivity of 2.65 × 10⁻¹. Last one is steel. Now we'll come to manufacturing properties. Copper and aluminium has all the properties like ductility, malleability and flexibility to manufacture the wire. Now we will come to density of conductors. Copper has a density of 8.96 g/cc. Then aluminium is 2.74 g/cc. While comparing copper and aluminium, aluminium is 3 times lighter than copper. It reduces the cable weight and cost. Now coming to coaxial cable conductors. There are 4 types of conductors used for coaxial cable. First one is solid copper. Second one is copper clad steel, that is CCS. Third one is copper clad aluminium, that is CCA. Last one is copper tube. Here in CCS, only outer side is copper and inner part is steel. In high frequency, we have one advantage, that is skin effect of conductor. We will see next slide about skin effect. Steel gives the higher strength and copper gives the good conduction. And also steel reduces the cost of cable. Same CCA, inner conductor is aluminum, outer is copper. Aluminum reduces the weight and cost of the cable. Now we will see skin effect of conductor. As frequency of signal increases, the transmission of signal goes outer towards the surface of conductor. In this picture, first one is DC current, means no frequency, that is zero frequency. Here current or signal passes through full conductor. Second one is AC current, that is in 50 to 60 hertz. Here small portion of middle is not used. Third one is higher frequency like gigahertz. In this, conduction is going in only circumference of conductors. About 3 micron thickness is sufficient for 1 gigahertz frequency. This is all about conductors. Now we will come to insulation. Any material that does not allow electric current pass through it is called insulator. For example, plastic, rubber, glass and cloth. Now we will see insulation material for cable. PVC is most common insulation material for low voltage cables. It is low cost material. Its normal working temperature is 70 to 105 degree Celsius and short circuit temperature is 140 degree Celsius. It creates halogen gases when it burns. It is harm to human health. The next one is PE. Polythene is mostly used for communication cable due to its low dielectric loss. The next one is XLPE. Its normal working temperature is 90 to 110 degree Celsius. Short circuit temperature is 250 degree Celsius. It has a better aging property. Next one is EPR. EPR is a copolymer of ethylene and propylene, and it is more flexible than XLPE and PE, and it is also same temperature range as XLPE. Now coming to insulation in coaxial cable. In coaxial cable, insulation is very important as a conductor. There are three types of insulation we can make. First one is solid PE, means there is no air inserted. Second one is chemical foaming. Here foam is created by chemical reaction. The compound itself designed like that. Here we can achieve maximum 40 to 45% foaming by adjusting extruder temperature. Third one is physical foaming. Here directly nitrogen gas inserted in extruder. Small air bubbles creates foam mixture of PE. Here we can achieve up to 70% of foaming. We are using only 30% of PE. From this we can not only saving material cost, it reduces the weight and losses in cable and increase the speed of transmission. This slide shows the comparison of three insulations. This is the one example of RJ11 cable. For TV transmission, 75 impedance is must. For achieving 75 ohm impedance, we have to maintain above diameters and weight. In solid PE, the foam percentage is zero, means there is no air inserted in the foam. In chemical foaming, we can achieve 45 to 50% of foaming. In physical foaming, we can achieve 65 to 75% of foaming. Impedance. Here 75 impedance is must for all three insulations. In solid PE, we can achieve only 66% of velocity. In chemical foaming, it is increased to 78%. In physical foaming, it is increased to 85%. Diameter of insulations 10.85 in solid PE. In chemical foaming, it is reduced to 7.72. In physical foaming, again it reduced to 7.11. Weight of PE in solid PE 83 kg per kilometer. In chemical foaming, the weight of PE is 22.63 kg per kilometer. In physical foaming, the weight of PE is 12.37 kg per kilometer. By seeing this table, we understand that in solid PE, by giving more material, we achieve only 66% of velocity. In physical foaming, by giving lesser material, we can achieve up to 85% of velocity. This slide shows the comparison of bubble formation in chemical foaming and physical foaming. This is physical foaming chart and this one is chemical foaming chart. Y-axis shows the foaming percentage and X-axis shows the bubble size in micron. In physical foaming, 70% of bubbles are same size, about 17 to 20 micron. Whereas chemical foaming showing the variation in bubble size. Bubble formation is major role for maintaining capacitance and diameter. Variation in bubble size affecting the line parameter. Slight changes in extruder temperature causing the too much variation in diameter and capacitance. In physical foaming, we can achieve uniform air bubbles. Therefore, no sudden effect on line parameter. Therefore, physical foaming insulation is the best for coaxial cable. Now comes to dielectric constant versus foaming. In power cable, resistance is important, but in communication cable, dielectric constant very important factor. All parameter of coaxial cable depends on this dielectric constant. For example, capacitance, impedance, velocity, time delay and attenuation. If dielectric constant decreases, then the quality of cable increases with all respect. Actually, P dielectric constant is 2.3 and dielectric constant of air is 1. We can't produce cable with air, but by inserting air in PE, we can reduce the dielectric constant near to 1. As foaming increases, dielectric constant decreases. This chart shows the dielectric constant versus foaming, and x-axis shows the foaming percentage and y-axis shows the dielectric constant. When foaming is 0, dielectric constant about 2.3 and it reduces the with respect to increase in foam percentage. Dielectric constant calculation in foam PE. Assume that foam is 70%, then dielectric constant of PE is 2.3 and dielectric constant of nitrogen is 1. 30% of PE is equal to 2.3 into 0.3 is equal to 0.69. Same, 70% of nitrogen is equal to 1 into 0.7 is equal to 0.7. The combination of both means the dielectric constant of foam PE is equal to 0.69 plus 0.7 is equal to 1.39. Therefore, the dielectric constant of foam PE is 1.39. After conductor and insulation, next one is sealed, that is braiding. Electric cable of one or more insulated conductor enclosed by common conductive layer, that is called braided. This picture shows LAN cable braiding. This one is copper braiding. And there is a one foil. After that, first braiding is there. After first braiding, another foil is there. And last one is second braiding. Means totally four layer is there, that is called quad sealed. Sealed may be made of conductive wires, braiding or conductive foil or combination of both. It may be two layer, three layer, four layer. As layer increases, radiation loss is decreases. this tape or foil bonding and overlap in sealed may be made of conductive wires braiding or conductive foil or combination of both. It may be 2-layer, 3-layer, 4-layer. As layers increases, radiation losses decreases. In this tape or foil is bonding and overlap is sealing in jacketing process. This APL tape protect to insulation from moisture entering inside. Braiding gives the flexibility to cable. As I told earlier, sealed is second conductor. It is barrier to external signal to internal signal. Because amplitude of coaxial cable is very small. That is also transmitting in the form of electromagnetic field. Any outer signal can disturb the inner signal. In free air, there are so many signals like mobile, radio, satellites. Now comes to final stage of process, that is jacketing. It gives the mechanical protection, protect the cable from ultraviolet radiation, printing on cable for identification. While jacketing, free heating is used for APL bonding. Jelly is used as waterproof to avoid oxidization of braiding.